Well, for those who've lost a loved one to war, Memorial Day takes on a bittersweet significance.
At the heart of the federal holiday is remembrance and honor for the military men and women who've died in service. And today, Maddie Garrett takes a look at the history and the meaning of Memorial Day. Maddie?
Originally known as Decoration Day, Memorial Day was first enacted to honor Union soldiers of the Civil War. But after World War I, it was extended to all fallen service men and women. And its history couldn't be better told than through a fallen hero from Cook County. His personal diary, original footage, and memories from family tell his story during World War II.
Well, I always looked up to him. I always thought... And everything that I'd ever heard about him was that he was so well respected in the community and the whole area, whole Cook County area, and everyone knew him.
Robert Weinzipfel was the oldest of eight brothers and sisters, their family well known and established in Munster in the early 1900s.
He was standing on the front porch, and I think he was getting ready to leave to go to California. And he picked me up and swung me around by my arms, and he said, "Henry, I'm leaving. I'm going to California." And that's my last memory of him.
When Henry Weinzipfel was 8 years old, his brother Robert left for the Navy as an ensign pilot. He was stationed on the USS Lexington in Hawaii just before the war in Europe reached American soil.
Robert got his start in a biplane exactly like this one, but his history and his story end right here in his diary.
I started reading through it, and I just thought, you know, this is... I just couldn't do it, you know. But I did read the last few entries tell about getting ready to go out on this mission.
Mary Burden, the youngest in the family, never knew her brother Robert, but felt a connection with him through his letters and old stories passed down. She reads his last entries.
At 0900, the Lexington received a radio message that there was a raid by Japan on Pearl Harbor. At first, everybody thought it was just a false alarm.
Through his words, written neatly in an old diary, there's a compassion and sense of duty in this young pilot.
But to pray for help in finding the enemy so I can bomb him and kill as many men as possible, well, it's just hard to do.
It was hard for him to pray that he could go out and kill someone. At the same time, he knew he had the duty to go out and try to protect his country and protect the other soldiers or sailors out on the ocean.
But those were the last words he wrote, because during a mission off the USS Lexington, something went terribly wrong.
We were landing, but he took a wave off, and we stalled and spun in.
She woke up about 6 o'clock in the morning and shaking Papa. She said, "Papa, Robert's in trouble. I know he's in trouble. I can feel him calling to me."
The family later found out it was about that time Robert died in the Pacific waters. It was December 9th, 1941. He was the first serviceman in Cook County to die in World War II.
The people who lived during World War II, who were adults at that time or who served, there's not that many left.
No.
The numbers are decreasing, so it's going to be more difficult maybe to keep the World War II element ideas alive.
This young naval pilot's story parallels so many other men and women who gave their lives serving their country and reminds all of us the reason we celebrate Memorial Day.
I think it's just something that we have to do, like have Memorial Day or Veterans Day or whatever, you know, just to keep in our memories, you know, the sacrifice that these people have made for our country and for us.
Most of the Weinzipfel family still live in Texas, some right here in Texoma. And the town of Munster still honors Robert and others who died in World War II with a special memorial in service on Sunday. Live in the